and I will focus on two points which are linked and in relation to the SDGs. So in relation to the SDGs, two points. The SDGs, one very important aspect of the SDGs is the question of poverty. And when you see the way it is addressed, okay, at least I have some problems. When the target is put in terms of 1.5 or $1.5, I think it's changing a little bit, but it's something like that. As the threshold for extreme poverty, it raises questions. For example, one question is $1 for a poor in India the same thing as $1 for Bill Gates, for example? And we speak of dollars, the same. This question has been addressed some time ago, and maybe we could try to explore it with a person. There was a very interesting work by a professor of Bombay University, Mumbai, Hari-Priya Gandhimeda, if maybe you know her. And the title of the study, of the research, is The GDP of the Poor. And I think that it's a very important point. In line with that, there was were papers in The Guardian last month about what it means, this question of a monetary threshold, with the fact that still a lot of poor are out of a monetary economy. And when they are monetized, then they get an increase of their standard. When sometimes it's in terms of well-being, it's a sharp decrease. They get an increase when they go from their field to a shanty town. So this is one point. And linked to that, money, as I understand from my studies, I made studies in economics also, sorry. Money is linked to debts. And we speak of debt crisis. And the debt crisis, you see that since this last 70 years, since the Second World War, it has very important consequences on the development and since the Washington Consensus and so on. And the question is, what about the historical debts, which can be economic debts, but it can be also ecological debts? Because the development of the West has been made during two centuries a lot by exploiting natural resources elsewhere. So this is my second question.